Hello students, myself Saurabh Palekar, Biology faculty from JNP College. In today's practical, we are going to study the different stages of meiosis using permanent slide. So usually in this experiment, for examination point of view, it will be kept for as a spotting, okay, wherein you need to identify the given specimen and comment on it with some special one or two points. So this question will be asked for 2 marks. Okay, so we'll move on to the experiment now. The aim of the experiment is to study the stages of meiosis using permanent slide. Principle: the meiosis is a reductional cell division in which the chromosome number is reduced to half of its original number. That means what? Here the cell which is diploid in nature, okay, that means a two pair of chromosomes when they are present, they are going to get reduced to half of its original number. Okay, like suppose in humans, if the humans have a normal 46 chromosomes in their body cell, so in this cell division, that is meiotic cell division, the daughter cell is going to receive 23 chromosomes. That means it is a half of its original number. It is also called a germ cell division because it occurs in the reproductive cells of the gonad. So those are nothing but gonad mother cells. Now meiosis includes two successive divisions. It is termed as meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Meiosis 1 is a reductional division where actual reduction of a chromosome count occurs, whereas meiosis 2 is an equational division. So here the meiosis 2 is also considered to be similar to mitosis. Okay, next, during interphase between the meiosis 1 and meiosis 2, there is no replication of chromosome. So only the time of meiosis 1, okay, before the meiosis 1 starts, during the interphase, the DNA replication is going to occur. But the second time, the DNA replication will not occur. Now, what are the requirements we need? Okay, so we require the permanent slides, okay, of the meiosis, and a compound microscope, okay, having a good magnification, okay, better, higher magnification. Next, observation, we need to observe the different slides under the microscope and observe and identify those stages, and we need to draw the labeled diagram. So moving on to the further concept. So before we go with the different stages, let us know the everything in just detail as a flow chart. So you see that the different stages of meiosis, they have been bifurcated into two successive divisions, right? They are meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. So the meiosis 1 is going to have two phases again. One is interphase and another is M phase. So M phase is nothing but meiosis 1 phase, which is a reductional division. The interphase will have three subphases, that is gap 1 phase, also abbreviated as G1. Next is synthetic phase, also called as S phase, and third is gapped 2 phase, also called as G2 phase. Okay. Now meiosis is further divided into two types depending upon what division is occurring. So first, the nuclear division takes place, that is nucleus is nothing but called as karyon. So division of nucleus is called as karyokinesis, and division of cytoplasm is called as cytokinesis. Since this process occurs in meiosis 1, it will be termed as, next further steps will be termed as karyokinesis 1 and cytokinesis 1. Next, under karyokinesis, there are 4 stages: the prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, and telophase 1. But the prophase 1 is the lengthiest of all the stages. Okay, so the prophase 1 itself is bifurcated into 5 sub-stages. Okay, those are leptotin, zygotin, pachytin, diplotin, and dikinesis. Okay, so these are the 5 stages. After this completion of 5 stages, starts with metaphase 1, anaphase 1, and telophase 1. After completion of telophase 1, it enters into cell division, that is cell cytoplasm division. That is what we call as cytokinesis 1. Once this is done, it enters into the next cell division, that is a meiosis 2. Under meiosis 2, there is two types, two phases. One is interkinesis and the meiosis, M phase, also called as meiosis two phase. Now, interkinesis is similar to the interphase. Only thing is, in interphase, the DNA division is going to occur, or DNA replication is going to occur, whereas in interkinesis, there is no DNA replication. Okay. So, meiosis 2 is similar to the mitosis. So, it is, the meiosis 2 is bifurcated into, as per the types of division, that is a nuclear division called as karyokinesis 2 and cytokinesis 2. The karyokinesis 2 is going to have four stages, that is prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2 and telophase 2. Then soon after completion of telophase 2, it enters into the cytokinesis 2. So this completes the process of meiotic cell division. So let us study each phase step by step. Okay. So moving on to the first step called as the interphase. So in interphase, it's also called as a preparatory phase, wherein the cell, earlier it was assumed that it was a resting stage, but it is not a resting phase. It is called as a preparatory phase because it has to prepare itself for its next cell division. Okay. During this phase, what happens is whatever the content it requires, like the DNA, the centrioles, the certain RNA, certain proteins, all this content, whichever it is requiring, they are going to be duplicated. Uska ek alternative copy ban jayega. Next, once this interphase is done, it will enter into the M phase, also called as meiotic one phase or meiosis one phase. Now, meiosis one is a reductional cell division in which a diploid parent cell produces two haploid cells, daughter cells. Okay. And here, since two haploid cells are produced from one diploid cell, it is going to be called as a reductional division. So under the microscope, this is how these are the cells, how they are going to be occurring in a interphase stage. Okay. Next, under the meiosis one stage, you will find different stages like prophase one, metaphase one, anaphase one, and telophase one. Under the prophase one, it is the longest phase of meiosis, having five stages, or you can say substages of it. Okay. Moving on to the first substage of prophase one, called as leptotene. So the term leptos refers to slender, tene refers to thread. If you observe the microscope, microscopic view, the cells are going to occur as if a slender thread-like structures. Okay, so those are having a chromatin network or chromosomes to be appearing as a slender thread-like structures. So what are the features here? So let us see. The chromatin, or you can say chromatin network, it condenses to form a chromosome. The chromosomes appear as long thread and thin and thread-like structure. Okay, they undergo coiling and become shortened and thicker. As and then the phases pass out to the next, the condensation of the chromosome is going to be condensation of chromatin network into the chromosome is going to be visible. So each chromosome, they show bead-like structure. So bead in the sense, a small granule-like structures. Okay, so it appears like beads. So bead-like structure are occurring, hence those structures are called as chromomeres. The telomeric end of all the chromosomes converge towards one side of the nuclear membrane. Therefore, they appear horseshoe-shaped structure. You can observe here, they appear like a horseshoe-shaped structure. Hence, the stage is also called as a banquet stage. Now, outside the nucleus in the cytoplasm, simultaneously at this time itself, the centrioles are formed into the esters, especially this occurs in an animal cell, whereas the esters are absent in a plant cell. Centrioles are absent in a plant cell. And they start to keep moving towards the opposite poles. So centrioles are in pairs and they move towards the opposite poles. At the same time, the spindle fibers are also begins to appear. Okay, so this is the stage of a leptotene. After the stage, it enters into the next substage called as a zygotene. So in zygotene, what happens? The chromosome it starts getting, the chromatin network starts getting condensed and much more thickly visible compared to leptotin. And here the pairing of homologous chromosome takes place, okay? And it forms a synapsis. So that pairing is called as a synapsis. So the pair will be called as a bivalent. So bivalent means two chromosomes which are similar, okay, they are going to be present side by side. So those will be considered to be a bivalent, okay? And this process of pairing is nothing but synapsis. Next, the chromosome continues to undergo condensation and the esters keep moving towards the opposite poles. At this, in this stage, the nucleolus tends to disappear. So this is a microscopic view wherein this is the microscopic view taken under the 40x magnification. Okay, that is 400 magnification, which was been observed. Next, under the pachytene stage. Okay, so the pachytene, okay, the pachy refers to thick. So here the chromosomes are much more coiled, much more tightened, much more shortened, and much more thickly visible and clearly visible. Okay, so in this stage, what happens? The bivalents which are present, okay, each bivalent show four chromatids. Okay, that means one chromosome is going to exhibit two chromatids. Okay, that means when the two chromosomes are in pairs, that means they exhibit four chromatids. Hence the term tetravalent. So this is a microscopic view of a pachytene stage. Okay, so in this stage, there is one more important point, that is nothing but a genetic crossing over. Okay, so in this stage, what happens? The exchange of a genetic material takes place between the two non-sister chromatids, okay, of a homologous chromosome. So you see, in a diploid set, the half of the set, okay, that means one set comes from the paternal side and another one set comes from the set of chromosome comes from the maternal side. Okay, so these two chromosomes will be having a similarity among themselves, okay, and these two chromosomes, they will overlap with each other. That means chromosome, the chromatid tip region which is there, it gets overlapped with each other, and when they get overlapped, the tip region gets exchanged between the two chromosomes. Okay, so that is what is considered to be a genetic crossing over. Okay, so this, due to this reason, this results into the genetic recombination, okay, and that which is responsible for a variation. So this is the main reason why each and every individual looks different from others, or looks different, have similar characters to the parents, but they are not like exact copy of a Xerox copy or a carbon copy of a parent. Okay, so there are the difference, the slight difference which is occurring is because of this genetic crossing over. Now the region at which this crossing over takes place, so that is the point at which this chromosomal tip region gets overlapped, okay, so that point is called as a chiasmata. So the chiasmata term is as a plural, and as a singular it is chiasma. Next, after completion of this pachytene stage, the fourth stage is diploidine stage. In diploidine stage, diplo refers to double. So the chiasma moves towards the tip region of the chromosomes as the homologous chromosomes of the bivalent starts moving apart. This event is called as terminalization. That means the tip region which is there, it starts to separate now. Now the chiasmata, it reaches towards the tip region of the chromosomal chromatid arm. So that process will be called as a terminalization. Next, the last substage of prophase 1 under meiosis 1, it is dikinesis. Di refers to opposite, kinesis is separation. So here the chromosomes at this stage appears thick, shortened, and distinct. The tip of some chromosomes show chiasmata. Okay, some of the chromosomes will exhibit chiasma formation, while in some of the chromosomes it will be separated. In this phase, what happens? The nucleolus and nuclear membrane completely gets disappear. So till this phase, right from the leptotin, the nucleolus and nuclear membrane, it starts to disintegrate slowly and slowly. But in the dikinesis, the nucleolus and nuclear membrane is completely disintegrated, and all the chromosomes are set free in the cytoplasm. Okay, so this completes the meiosis, the prophase 1 of meiosis 1. The next step will be the metaphase one. Okay. So after prophase, the metaphase one. So in this stage, what happens? The centrioles, they produces the spindle fibers, and the spindle fibers are connected to both the poles of the cell. So they also get passed through the centromere of the chromosome, and they help in aligning all the chromosomes towards the equatorial region. So that means they're exactly at the center of a cell. Okay, all the cells are, all the chromosomes are lined in a at the equatorial region of the cell. So in this, in such a manner wherein the centromeres, which are present, the center of this chromosome, the centromere, they are facing towards the pole, whereas the chromosomal tip region, they are facing towards the equatorial region, that is the center of a cell. So after completion of after completion of metaphase one, it enters into anaphase one. So in this phase, is very important. Okay, in anaphase one, what happens? The centromeres do not undergo longitudinal splitting. That means there is no longitudinal splitting between the chromatid arms. Rather, the entire chromosome, rather out of these two chromosomes, one chromosome moves towards one end, another chromosome moves towards the opposite end. So entire chromosome is moved towards the opposite poles. So by the activity of spindle fibers. So this is called as a separation or disjunction of chromosome. Okay, so usually in mitosis, what happens? The chromatids get separated. That means the centromeres undergoes longitudinal splitting from that one individual chromosome. Two chromatids are formed, and each chromatid will be moving towards the opposite pole. But in meiosis one, okay, under the anaphase one stage, the entire chromosome is shifted here. So here it is exhibiting the reduction within the cell. Okay. So after completion of anaphase one, it enters into the telophase one. Okay. So in telophase one, what happens? The homologous chromosomes separates and reaches towards the opposite poles. Okay. The nucleus, the nuclear membrane reappears, and even the nucleolus starts to reappear. And the spindle fibers, they tend to disappear, and this phase will eventually end into the cytokinesis. So in some cases, the cell will undergo cytokinesis. That means cell wall formation is, or the cell division is going to occur, or cytoplasmic division is going to occur. Whereas in certain, most of the cases, what happens after telophase, it immediately enters into the prophase two stage. Okay, so after completion of this cytokinesis, the next phase, that is a meiosis two stages. Okay, under this meiosis two, you'll find first is the interkinesis. So interkinesis is very short lived. Okay, usually after telophase, it has to undergo the process of interphase, wherein DNA duplication has to occur. But in meiosis two, the DNA duplication will never occur, and sometimes even interkinesis stage will not be present, and it immediately enters into the prophase two stage. So let us move on to the karyokinesis. So under the karyokinesis, that is a nuclear division two. Okay, here the in this stage you will find the four stages, that is prophase two, metaphase two, anaphase two, and telophase two. So if you look this, look at the microscopic view, the cell appears like this. Okay, so wherein the cell is going to undergo prophase two, wherein the chromosomes are undergoing condensation. Okay, again for the second time, then the spindle fibers are about to reappear, the nuclear membrane and nucleolus, it starts to disintegrate and disappear. So by the time it reaches the metaphase stage, almost towards the metaphase stage, that is late prophase stage, the nucleolus and nuclear membrane is completely disappeared. Okay, in the metaphase stage, all the chromosomes which are present, okay, they are lined towards the equatorial plate of this cell, okay, towards the center of the cell. Now in at this stage, they are lined towards the center with the help of spindle fibers, okay, that run passes through the some of the spindle fibers connect to the chromosomes through the centromeres. Okay, now here the what do we say, the all the chromosomes are going to be aligned in a equatorial plate, and then it enters into the anaphase 2 stage. In anaphase 2 stage, it is similar to mitosis, wherein there is a longitudinal splitting of a chromosome is going to occur. So the centromeres of all the chromosomes undergo longitudinal splitting. So if you recall the anaphase 1, there was no longitudinal splitting, and entire chromosome was shifted towards the opposite pole, okay, out of this homologous pair. Here what happens, there is a single chromosome, but the chromatid arm, okay, the chromatid arms are going to be undergoing longitudinal splitting, and it gets separated towards the opposite poles. So this is a microscopic view of anaphase 2. Next, the next phase is nothing but the telophase 2. So telo refers to end, okay, ana refers to opposite, meta refers to at the towards the center. The telophase 2 stage, in this stage the chromosomes arrive at the poles and undergo decondensation, okay. So if you recall the prophase, in prophase it undergoes condensation, that means it undergoes coiling. Here it undergoes decoiling, okay, it uncoils, okay, and it's also called as decondensation, okay, and it becomes a long chromatin fiber, or you can say chromatin network. Then in this stage itself, the nucleolus and nuclear membrane, it begins to reappear slowly, and the spindle fibers which were been present during time of cell division, it gets disappear in telophase stage. Soon after the telophase stage, it enters into the cytokinesis 2. So cyto refers to the cell and or cytoplasm, and kinesis refers to movement or division, you can say. So it is a division of a cytoplasm, and a clear furrow develops in the middle of the cell in a centripetal direction. Okay, centripetal direction means from the periphery towards the center of a cell, the cleavage, in the sense some breaking of the cell is going to be occurring, and this is done because of the contraction of the microtubules which are present inside the cell. So it occurs till the edges of the plasma membrane meet. So this completes your today's practical.